Launch Yammer using this icon. This is what Yammer looks like when you launch it for the first time and you are the first person to use Yammer. Pretty empty and lonely, but perhaps quite good for identifying initial elements that you'll always find in Yammer, no matter how active the community already is. First, there's the rather obvious request to start a discussion. Let me write a first post. The post will then appear below here. Oh, someone has already liked my post. Sure, others might write a reply too, and I can reply to that in turn. So far, pretty simple. But if everyone goes ahead and writes, "Hi, how are you?" the point of Yammer is missed. It's about purposeful discussions in a community, meaning a group of people with the same interests. Well, I think with my message, a good start has now been made here. But obviously, more is possible here, namely the options to ask a question, to praise someone, or to start a poll. Interesting. I'll go into these options again in a moment. But first, I want to explain the menu bar up here. On the far left, you'll find the App Launcher, with all the other lovely Microsoft 365 applications. The search box here does exactly what you'd expect. If you click here, you'll see the other people who are also registered in Yammer. So here you'll find all the people from your organization who have a Microsoft 365 account and with whom you can communicate here. Since Yammer recently got a new design, you can switch back to the old design here. But it doesn't make sense, as the button will probably disappear after a short transition period anyway, so don't be surprised if you don't see it anymore. The bell shows if you have received a notification. You'll get a notification, for example, when someone responds directly to a post of yours, you were at mentioned, or one of your answers to a question was flagged as best answer. This useful option is also available. And you can provide feedback to Microsoft. In the settings, you can see some settings that only an administrator has. But you can also change overall settings that affect all Microsoft 365 applications here. So, for example, you can customize the appearance and change the language or password, and you can also make Yammer-specific setting changes. For example, like turning on and managing the desktop notifications. This way, you would be notified even if the Yammer browser window is not your focus at the moment. However, think twice about whether you want to turn on desktop notifications. It mainly depends on how you use Yammer. Are the messages you receive urgent? Is someone else waiting for the answer? Or is it also enough if you open Yammer 2 to 3 times a day, check for news, and then respond to it? You can also designate other people to post and respond to posts in Yammer on your behalf. This will probably make more sense for people who are higher up in the hierarchy, or even, for example, if you're on vacation and want Yammer conversations to continue on your behalf. Makes sense, right? If you are a member of multiple Yammer environments, you can switch between them. Normally, you are a member of only one environment. Nothing wrong with that. Furthermore, there is a help function. This is not Yammer specific, but provides results for all Microsoft products. Fortunately, you don't have to dig through there, because instead, you're learning how to use Yammer with the help of this training. A wise decision. Last but not least, here you can log out of Yammer. This is probably as often as you log out of Facebook. Namely, almost never, right? What I mean to say is that it's not really necessary to log out each evening, for example. Let's now move on to the left menu bar. In the home feed, you can see all the activities. In the inbox, you can see the conversations you follow. This way, you can keep an overview. I'll explain more functions about the inbox later. And then there are the communities here. So far, there is apparently only one community, the All Company. And maybe you noticed, my first message went to everyone in the company. Oops. That can be quite, let's say, unintentional with thousands of members. At this point, you have learned something important in dealing with Yammer. Always pay close attention to which community you post to. You may not see this button called Create a Community. That's because this is a look behind the scenes for you. I'm going to create a new community, Health and Safety at the Workplace. And in the description, I've decided to add a mission statement. Additional members can be added to this group to ensure that key stakeholders have access to the community. By default, a community is public, but can be changed to private so that only the listed members can access the community. This can be useful for managing product development or projects that are not yet due to be released. It may even be that in some communities, not everyone can start a conversation, but only certain people. This restriction is often used to keep Yammer tidy, because if everyone can create a community, it can get crowded and confusing, which, in extreme cases, would make good communication no longer possible. I will now create two more communities, the sales team community and one for legal. Communities do not necessarily have to be departments. They can also be based on interests, for example, project management, best practice, or even surfing. In the best practice community, project managers can exchange information about new techniques in project management or about tips and tricks in software. In addition, new courses on MS projects could be posted here, for example, and perhaps even a virtual regulars table could be created. The surfing community might exchange information about surf spots or about buying and selling equipment. Joint events may also be planned here, and it is not uncommon for friendships to develop through the communities. The communities are not necessarily only about company issues. I hope you could see from these examples what is possible with Yammer, and maybe you already have some ideas of your own regarding how you want to use Yammer. You can also mark certain communities as your favorite to enable quick access to them. Since I created these communities here myself, I am the first and so far only member. But other people can also join here. And, oh, here is already another person who has become a member of one of my communities. Here you can see an example of another community which I did not create myself. I'll join that one, and of course, it's easy to leave. So, that was a first important step in Yammer. You can now actively participate. The many advantages of Yammer and how to successfully use Yammer will come in the following trainings. See you later!